Well, good morning. Well, I do start seeing you checking in. It's Wednesday. I hope I'm in the camera here. I've moved the camera around a little bit. And today it's going to be something kind of simple. It's been, shall we say, taken up a notch. Today it's going to be cream of broccoli soup. The basic ingredient on that is going to be a package of Bear Creek. Hope you can see it. I'm not getting paid by them, by the way, but I do like their products, Bear Creek Cheddar Broccoli Soup Mix. That's the basis we're starting with. It will be enhanced along the way. Right now the water's warming up here, so just start this off with 8 cups of boiling water, and then we'll go from there. So I'm going to let the pot boil, and it'll boil quicker if I'm not watching it, so I do South Senior. Checking out for a few minutes. Well, good morning again, Lloyd Dussault Sr. I'm back. Looks like the water's boiling. Sure is. So, guess it's time to get this show on the road. It's pretty simple, actually. I've got one other ingredient that I'm going to go fetch here off camera. Here it is. Okay, this whole recipe consists of 8 quarts of water boiling, and cheddar soup mix is mixed in. Whisk the soup mix in, reduce the heat, simmer and cover for 10 minutes, stirring occasionally, salt and pepper to taste. Sounds pretty easy, doesn't it? Well, let's get this show on the road. A few additions to what they have here. Get the water boiling a little bit, I turn it down. Well, we're going to mix this in. I've done this before, and it's, not my favorite, because it's mixing in fairly slow, because it kind of wants to, that almost works better. There we go. Kind of clumps up if you don't whisk it in well. That's what I'm doing. I hope you can see this. I've changed my camera angle. It's a friend saying, hey, Lloyd, you might want to see if there's a better way you can do that so you can be, they can, folks can hear you a little better. And I agree. Now, in she goes. And all by itself, Bear Creek soup is pretty doggone good, even if you don't, shall we say, take it up a notch. All right, there's the last of it. All right, so what we're going to do is whisk all that in there. Like that, break up all the clumps, hopefully. It does take a little bit of time, but it's worth it. Get nice and creamy. I go in one direction and kind of like reverse it a little bit. All right, so that's done. Soup mix is in. Now we're going to add approximately 1.5 cups of fresh broccoli that's all been chopped up. That's going to go in there. So we're adding a little bit of body to it. But wait, there's more. Let's have patience. We're going to turn that heat down. We don't want to boil that over. So we have the broccoli added to it, the added broccoli, I should say. And what we have here is 20 Swedish meatballs, frozen Swedish meatballs that I purchased at a local market here. We have a market basket, supermarkets up here in New England. Uh-huh. You may have heard of them on the news a few years back when the folks were all on strike trying to keep their jobs and helping the owner of the company prevent a hostile takeover. So what we're doing is we're putting 20 meatballs in here, Swedish meatballs. It may sound funny, but I've done this before, and everybody that has tried it said, that's pretty doggone good. So all the goodies are in here. Those meatballs are frozen, so they're going to bring the temperature down a little bit. So while they're defrosting, they're all cooked. Oh, what do you know about that, huh? Sometimes, there we go. They're cooked, they just need to thaw out and get up to temperature. So, it's almost 10:45, and this is going to go on a low simmer on the back. It's one of my favorite things with my stove, is I have a couple trivets here, cast iron thing and the heat disperser. And I will be putting the soup on the back burner and letting it simmer there till lunchtime at a very low heat. And that'll let everything work in together. All the flavors will work in, hopefully. And then we'll let you know how it worked out. So this is a pretty short one for a Wednesday lunch menu. But I guarantee that if you do make it, you will truly enjoy it. Because I've done this before, so I know how this comes out. Lloyd Dusselt Sr. checking out for the moment. Well, Lloyd Dusselt Sr. checking back in. It's 11:49. I expected my diners to join me shortly. I have two guests for dinner, or lunch, I should say, today. And so we have three bowls out. The stew. Stew, yeah, right. Cream of broccoli soup is sitting in the back here, which is a long shot, I guess, from the camera, but with a little bit of luck, I will give a shot of ladling it out, and you can see what it all looks like as it goes into the bowl. So, Lloyd Dusselt Sr. checking out, and it's almost time for lunch. Well, it's time for lunch. I thought we were going to have three of us dining today, but I misunderstood something about a week ago. It's going to be next week there may be three of us. So it's the big two today, just Paul and I. And, okay, the camera's on. The cream of broccoli soup is made, done. And I'm going to ladle it out. Got the meatballs in there. And I got the fresh broccoli mixed in. And looks mighty good to me. Hope it looks as good in the camera. I'm sure Paul and I will enjoy this. There we go. Okay, plenty of meatballs for everybody in here. Let's see, did I miss one for Paul? Oh, I think I cheated him. Can't do that. There we go. All right, well, shut off the camera. I hope you enjoyed the quick cooking lesson today. There wasn't too much to it, but it does make a pretty doggone good lunch. Lloyd Dusselt Sr. checking out. Gonna have some lunch. Well, lunch is over with. And there's some leftovers. Due to my miscalculation, I thought we were having three for lunch today, but I was wrong. It's next week. So there was only two of us. Nevertheless, the cream of broccoli soup with the Swedish meatballs was absolutely delicious. I guess I'd better take a look here, yes. And we have 1, 2, 3 packages, containers, each one of them holding 18 ounces of soup. So that's a good feed for anybody. I'll probably put one in the fridge and two in the freezer, and when I get hungry for cream of broccoli soup, I'll take it out of the freezer and defrost it, and I'm sure I'll enjoy it. So, Lloyd Dusselt Sr. checking out. Hope you enjoyed the recipe, and try it sometime. I think you'll like it.